May God bless the reading of his words. Amen. You can take the picture of Simon and his partners by the lake trying to fish, and it's advisable to fish during night hours. The Bible says that they tried to fish, but they caught nothing. They tried their level best as talented fishermen, as men who had knowledge or of the sea, as men who had been fishing on that very same lake for many years. They tried their level best, but they caught nothing until morning. So they abandoned. They left their boats. They left their boats and they started cleaning the nets. Yet Jesus Christ arrived. And when Jesus Christ arrived, he called Peter and told him that, "Hey Peter, try to take the boat a little deeper. Go back into the lake a little deeper." So Peter said that, "We have tried all the night. We have tried our level best so that we can catch some fish, but to no avail." So as you are speaking, because it's you, Lord, who is saying things by your word, we are going to let the boat a little bit deeper. We are going to fish, because you are the one who has said that we should go back into the lake and we are going to catch fish. It doesn't matter what time of the day it is. It doesn't matter. Fish is always caught during night hours. But because it's you, the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings, we are going to catch ours and they went back into the sea. And they lowered the nets. They trapped a lot of fish. The Bible said that. They even signaled the others who were in that other boat to come and help them. So they came and they helped them. But Peter now was surprised. How come, as we are talented people, as we are talented fishermen, as we are talented on this sea, we got nothing? But because of your might, when we just lower our boats a little bit deeper, we have caught a lot. You must be the Lord of Lords and King of Kings. And then it says, Jesus Christ told them that you will be fishers of men from today onwards. You will be fishers of men. Upon not fishing the fish, you must be fishing people now. That's why our title is Fishers of Men. Hallelujah. Amen.
Lamps.
And when the fish see the light, I'm telling you, I'm saying it to myself again. There are situations where God, Jesus Christ, is telling us nowadays, you have been in a situation, you have been in a situation as a church, whereby you try to catch another fish, but you don't catch none. And you don't catch any fish, you catch none. Absolutely nothing. As a church, targets on people so that people can be caught, can be fished, but you have changed none. Today, Jesus Christ is saying to you, as a church, I want to hear you say it. Go a little bit less. The Bible said that Peter, he did not ask you Jesus Christ. Hey, Lord. No. Most of the times, when Jesus says it, you must just do it. When Jesus says it, you must just do it. There is a problem with those marriages. When Jesus says that you must life. When Jesus Christ says it, you just do it. It's for him to be shy because he has told you something which is not working. Hallelujah. But most of the times, we look at good things. No, how do I do it? How do I stop? No, I love you. And you know, we are giving him a lot of faith, Jesus. But I tell you, are you going to do what Jesus is going to tell you now? Are you going to do what Jesus Christ is telling you now?
Yes.
I can see a lot of us. We have tried looking for it. Some of us, we are trying to looking for it. But there is none. You know the problem? Jesus Christ does not come from heaven and tell you what to do. He uses people who are on this earth to tell you what to do. Most of us, we want to see Jesus coming from heaven and tell us what to do. Yet Jesus Christ uses those people who are close to you and tell you what to do, but you stop looking at them. Okay.
Amen.
There are many of us. Many of us. Here. Who are married. Many of us who are married. You have tried your level best, man. As a man, you have tried your level best. Trying to make your family work. But the family is not working. And today, Jesus Christ is saying unto you, go a little bit deeper.
Amen.
Go a little bit deeper. How do you treat your wife matters more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I can see some women trying their level best to bring into the house peace, but there is no peace. And today I'm telling you, Jesus Christ is saying that try a little bit deeper. It's not a matter of going to Zambora and give you some loot. No, it's not about that. Try a little bit deeper. Try a little that you should try a little bit deeper. You know, to go deeper is not a joke.
Yes.
To go deeper is not a joke. Yes. Because the deepest presence of the sea is where the dangerous animals hide.
Yes.
There are a lot of things taking place on that deepest level of the sea. It's very dangerous to go there.
Yes.
Hallelujah. If you can start telling our deeds the problem. The problem is not the Bible. The problem is not Jesus Christ. The problem is you and me. We are the problem. You see, how do we become the problem? Because we are switching off the lights. We are switching off the lights. And as a fisherman, how will fish recognize that there is someone else there? How are they going to recognize when you have switched off your light? Are you a fishers of men?
Amen.
Do you want to become a fishers of men?
Yes.
No, I don't get someone says no, I don't want. Who is it? Do you want to become fishers of men?
Yes.
No, I don't hear it. When something is very good, you appreciate it. Do you want to become fishers of men?
Yes.
If you want to become fishers of men, try to change yourself. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Try to change yourself. Try to change yourself. As you try to change yourself, even those people out there who also try to change themselves without you preaching.
Amen.
I want to tell you, try to go a little bit deeper. My sister, my brother, I know you have been going through a lot of things. You want to change those people whom you are living with, but you don't try to change yourself. How can you change those people who are around you? My teacher told me something else. He asked me a question. If you have been given a chance today to change even just one single thing outside there, if you have been given a chance, just imagine yourself where you are. You have been given a chance that change something today. Should not be in the way it was before. You have been given a chance. The door is open. Go outside there. We are going to fail. Some other people will try to remove the bricks outside there and put them somewhere else. Hallelujah. So I gave him a wrong answer as you are giving me myself. That answer of yours. He told me one thing. If you want to change one thing in a day, and that the world should recognize that there was something, and today it's changed, it's you yourself who can change yourself.
Yes.
Are you trying to change yourself today? Are you trying to change yourself today? You know when people change themselves, you don't say, I am a panache. People just recognize you before you tell them that you are a real panache.
Yes.
Are we together?
Yes.
What is the matter? No, I'm a panache. You are drinking beer. A panache. You are smoking. A panache. You are stealing from God. A panache. How come people should just know? You don't tell them my friends. You don't tell them my congregation. You don't tell them the congregation of God. They tell you themselves. Hallelujah. They tell you themselves that my brother, you are a born again. I see the way you behave with your wife in the house. I see you the way you behave here at the wedding place. people to represent you. You isolate yourself from these people. You stay there. Like we see you representing in the community. When people are complaining against this and that, you just isolate you and yourself there. We see you when your child is in trouble. The way you treat that child, you isolate from the rest of the world. I tell you, if you can change yourself, I tell you, 2 to 3 months, we will not be coming here again. I will see there will be no space here. You see what happens? We are running short of time. You see what happens? Let me tell you this. They caught a lot. They caught a lot. And they failed to pick themselves. So they called the neighbor. They called those people who were there with them to help them. You know what the Bible says most of the times? It says that don't ignore your relatives, especially those whom you are praying together with. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Especially those whom you are praying with. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible puts first the spiritual brothers, the spiritual sisters, the spiritual mothers, the spiritual grandmothers. They are the first than your physical grandmother, than your physical mother, than your physical father, than your physical sister, than your physical brother. They are very different.
Amen.
They're in a special way because you believe in the same thing. Hallelujah. In the church. These are your neighbors in the church. When they caught a lot of the fish, they called the neighbors. They called the neighbors. Come and help us, please. We have got blessings from the Lord. Are you calling the neighbor when you are blessed? Are you calling the neighbor when you are blessed? Are you calling the neighbor? Are you calling the neighbor? Are you eating the blessings of the Lord? Are you eating with the neighbor? Most of the people, they forget that these, the first four disciples, they call their neighbor, please neighbor, come and help us. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Are you coming, your neighbor? Are you coming, your spiritual brothers? Are you coming, your spiritual sisters? Are you coming, your spiritual mothers? Are you coming, your spiritual fathers? Are you coming, your spiritual grandfathers? Or your spiritual cousins? Where are they of now as we are speaking? They are decaying while you are there. You're not calling them for your presence. Hallelujah. For the presence God has given unto you, share to your spiritual brother. Share to that spiritual neighbor who is close to you. But we even, when we see someone struggling on the way, whom we pray with, we just say, he thinks he's better than us at the church. Just driving faster, he will not even recognize the number plate. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, I want to tell you now that you are the fishers of men. Try to go deeper. Try to go deeper. Fish people with your teeth. Fish people with your habits. Fish people with the way you dress. Fish people with the way you talk. Fish people with the way you eat. With the way you drink also. Fish people. The community will be changed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To your neighbor. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I've seen someone says that I want to change. Come out. Those who say that I have not been doing this. Come out. Come out. I've not been doing this. Stand up. Stand up. Everyone who feels that I have never done this. I have never done this. The blessings or the light. I'm not the light. When the community sees me, I'm not the light. Can you stand up? We are running short of time. Yes, you brother. I've seen you for a long time ago. You stand up. Stand up, my brother. Stand up, my brother. Stand up. My brother. Stand up. My brother. Stand up. Not be trouble for white someone. Sir, stand up. My brother, stand up. Yes, amen. 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 Yeah, no, just there. Just there. Don't worry. Stand up there. Stand up there. This is offerings. This is offerings. He has been traveling the first room. I've seen him. So these are offerings. We want to pray. have stood up with me will kneel down with me in prayer as we are cleansing, and therefore the offerings will fall. Amen?
Amen.
Let us all kneel down in prayer. You all who stood up with me, let us kneel down.
Now, hallelujah.